Hello YouTube, this is Darkon633, and today is another review in the Star Wars The Force Awakens Blade Builders lightsaber toy line. Now I got this lightsaber recently from Toys R Us, and I've been contemplating for a long time ever since this was announced if I was going to get Anakin Skywalker's lightsaber based on Revenge of the Sith. Since, in continuity-wise, it's actually based on Luke's lightsaber, and obviously Luke's lightsaber is a huge debate over it over the years. It's obviously not the same exact looking blade, but continuity-wise, it is supposed to be the same thing. So, in any other purposes for the rest of the video, I'm just going to be considering this, at this moment, Luke's version of his lightsaber from A New Hope, and kind of into Empire Strikes Back, since that changed again later, too. But anyways, we'll take a look at just this thing quickly. Just the little hook where it held the lightsaber. There isn't a whole lot to it, just like the Luke one. And we'll take a look at the handle itself. Now, I think this is a really nice handle. I think Hasbro's done a nice job making a pretty good handle for adult hands. Definitely good for a kid's hands, but in adult hands, it's still pretty decent. It is of a non-electronic version, so this is a part of the basic line. You know, all it does is, when you flick it, it does bring out the blade itself. But the sculpt of the handle itself is really impressive. I really like the silver, and besides the fact that there's a few scratches here and there, and there's another one down here somewhere and so on. It's still a really nice silver, and I think it's pretty well made. We'll now extend it. Take a look at the saber, and it is the blue color like it's supposed to, so that's nice. Now close it off and put it down for now. And I'll be back to show a little example of how the blade looks like attached to another saber. And we're back. Just to show a comparison with the hilts, here is the basic Luke lightsaber hilt, which I've already reviewed. And here it is compared to the Revenge of the Sith Anakin hilt, which is pretty much the same length. It's a bit longer up here just by the way that the blade was, or should I say the hilt was designed. But it's still a pretty nice fit together. Here they are compared lengthwise. They're the same length since they are both in the basic line, so they made the length of the blades the same. So that's really nice. And we're now connected using the Blade Builder's adapter to Luke's lightsaber, just to show an example how it looks like combined. So we're going to snap that in, and then there we go. So this is really cool that Hasbro's designed a toy line that allows you to extend it like that. So I'm just going to quickly extend it outward on both sides. Show how it looks like together. And I really wish there was a way I can get this into frame better, since it looks really nice together, and it's kind of ironic that I put both of these blades together. Let's see. So here's the blue one connected there and so on. So it's got a really nice length, and I really wish there was an easier way for me to show this on camera, but it does work really nicely. And just to show how it looks like with one end closed, here it is. But obviously, we're going to show again both ends closed. This. So it does have a lot of heft to it once connected. And it'd be nice if they actually release a Darth Maul lightsaber like this. And even though it's going to be kind of ridiculous to get two lightsabers for $10 a piece, since that's the normal retail for the sabers, I think this is still pretty nice together. And just to show how it looks like with the blue end extended, I think it works really nicely, and it's really cool that Hasbro's designed these really nice hilts. So even though it's obviously made for a kid's toy line, and a lot of adult collectors might go for the full-on FX lightsabers or the removable blade ones from Hasbro and so on, they're still part of the FX line and so on, but for a person under a budget, I think this is a really nice way to get a hold of these sabers. And it does have a little piece which I think can be used as a way to clip onto a belt or something. So it does work really nicely, and once again it does have a really nice fit in adult hands. So I think this is definitely worth it, especially if you're a Star Wars fan, and those who are maybe just big fans of lightsabers in general. So anyways, please comment, subscribe, and check out Hirotaku and the Gideon blog as soon as they reopen up. Also, please check out my Twitter handle, @Darkon633. Please check down the other channels down below, including the WW Podcast and more. But for now, I'll be seeing you YouTube. Bye.